Hi, good evening, everybody, and welcome to another glorious Hump Day Wednesday evening Turning Point. Your last one of the month and the year. Here is your Turning Point for Wednesday, December 29th, 2021. Episode 123. Excuse me. Sorry about that. Today we're going to be talking about spirit. This evening's Devo, we're going to be talking about spirit of the mind. Our beginning passage, Ephesians 4:23. Your recommended reading is Romans 12, 1 and 2, which is the one about the living sacrifice passage. I know the verse, I just can't say it all without looking at it. I'll have to look at it, and then I'll be able to say it. But your turning point is from Jeremiah Johnston, PhD, which there is a footnote from him in the second paragraph. This little paragraph right here, where my finger is. And there's a footnote right down here at the bottom from the same guy. So, sorry for the darkened screen, but that's what happens when you put the book up real close to it. But, if you're excited about this one, the last Hump Day Wednesday, smash that like button. Comment what you, once again, comment something that you want to happen in the new year, or you're looking forward to something happening next year. Some big event or some special birthday or something, special anniversary, you name it, whatever it is, you're looking forward to it in the new year. And if you're doing something in the month of January, are you looking forward to it, and what is it that you're looking forward to? But subscribe if you're new, turn on notifications, share the video and channel with your family and friends, and help me reach that goal of what was 100 subscribers, but I don't think I'm going to be able to get it by then. But I can still say it. But at least get 25 to 50 subscribers by January the 15th, which is 17 days. See, 30, 31. Yeah, 17 days. And which at least 2 days left in 2021. And at midnight Friday night, we say goodbye to 21 and turn around and say hello to 22. And say, hello 2022. Hope you're a lot better than 21 was to a bunch of us. Because I know I will be saying it. If y'all haven't already understand what me and my family went through the 1st of October. Losing my brother. But I'm not going to go any further than that. I don't want to get... We're still going through paperwork, or we're still going through paperwork to get a second life insurance policy that he had taken out, sent to us, that we didn't know. We knew about the first one, and then they come up and said there was a second one for an accidental policy, which surprised us, and it's going to be the same amount as the first one. That is what it is, so. But let's go on. Spirit of the mind. And be renewed in the spirit of your mind. Ephesians 4:23. And let's get the recommended reading out of the way. Before I forget, your Bible reading is Revelation 14-17. I forgot to say that just a few minutes ago. But Romans 12:1-2 is about the living sacrifice. I almost turned right to it. Or was that? No, that's Acts. That was Acts. Sorry about that. I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, wholly acceptable to God, which is your reasonable service. And do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is... what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. But make your bodies a living sacrifice, wholly acceptable to God, and do not be conformed to this world. It's your key phrases from that. But be transformed, that you may prove what is that perfect will of God. Or whatever that is. What a phrase! The spirit of your mind. We need the truth to refresh our thoughts and give us a basis for sound thinking, mental health, and personal transformation. When we believe the truth, we're grounded in a biblical worldview. So Jeremiah Johnston, PhD, he wrote, faith and the mind are not at odds. Faith is not believing nonsense. Faith is not embracing unreasonable, illogical things. In short, faith is not stupid. Some people even seem to have faith in faith, as Dawkins and other atheists have in fact pointed out. Faith is intelligent. It is educated. It is learned. It is hungry for understanding. A healthy faith is a seeking faith. Amen? A healthy faith is not satisfied to be ignorant. Ooh. To be naive, to remain in the dark, or to pass on misinformation. That is a footnote for this one. That is taken from an article or something wrote from Jeremiah Johnston, and it was titled, Do You Think Christianity? From something called the Christian Thinkers Society. And that was done on August the 10th, 2020. And you could probably find that article on the website christianthinkers.com. You could find that, must be an article from that website. But I'll be sure to leave that information in the description of this video, in the description box. I will read that, I will leave that footnote in the description box, which I'll include the website. And all you got to do is highlight it. If it don't come out as a link on your side, highlight it, right click it, the menu will come up and go down and say go to, and then it'll go say go to the website, and then it'll go right to it. So, but God in his wonder and glory gave us the ability to think and reason. We're to love him with all our minds, and sadly at times we use those gifts for misguided purposes. But if we stop and ponder our life in the light of our Creator, that's a journey worth taking. Amen? So Jeremiah Johnston again says, one of the most dangerous places to be is when we don't seek the truth. And the easiest way to eliminate confusion is to know the truth. Wow. But that's all I have for today. Your turning point for tomorrow, for Thursday, December 30th, 2021, episode 124. We're going to be talking about where there's smoke. Sorry about that, my vehicle. Beginning with 2 Samuel 14:14 from the NIV version. And I'll be sure to read my version in my Bible. And your recommended reading is 1 Timothy 1, 12 through 17. We'll be reading that one. And your turning point is from William Reed Newell. N-E-W-E-L-L. All from the hymn at Calvary. There my burdened soul found liberty at Calvary. Get it? So that's what we'll have tomorrow. Your passages for tomorrow, real quick. Your morning passage for your Days of Praise passage, episode 584, part 1. We're going to be talking for Thursday, December 30th. We're going to be talking about our job as ambassadors, beginning with 2 Corinthians 5, verse 20. Your part two for 584, your daily bread passage, no bonus Devo. Today was the last bonus Devo, so no more bonus Devos. So we'll just have the one called Better Than Gold, Patricia Rayburn, derived from Proverbs 3, 13 through 18. So stay tuned to that. Sometime today I'll get to it. IRL. And you'll be seeing all those tomorrow. But until then, I love you. I appreciate you. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Keep on keeping on and trust in God, and He'll keep you safe in all you say and do. And until tomorrow, peace out, everybody. Goodbye. God bless. Have a wonderful rest of your glorious Hump Day Wednesday evening. Come back tomorrow for another blessed, thankful Thursday, the last one of the month and last one of 2021. Just two more days and 21 will end. So, the year is close to an end. So, but until tomorrow, see ya.